flat it out and put a diesel in it.
Is this a radio back here, or?
Yeah, that's a shortwave receiver. We'll see. I take it the B-17's in the air right now. You guys get a ride on it?
Yep.
Yeah.
How'd you like it?
No, we're going to.
Oh, you're gonna. It's worth every dime of it, gentlemen. I did it about 3-4 years. Well, actually, it's been about 6 years. It's amazing.
Yeah, we got the bombardier seats right up front.
It's a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
That's what I said.
It's a once-in-a-lifetime experience. At that price?
What?
Door pockets. Let's put your stuff in.
Good thing we're just stuff like the Coca-Cola.
How far back you want everybody to walk with
you? I mean, as long as I like.
I mean, this light red line is not a good spot.
No.
You want to be on that red line, that red and white line back there?
I didn't think they had seats here. I always figured that they nailed her or something. Because in movies like Black Hawk Down, you see him practically leaning out.
Black Hawk Down, this could be a redesigned aircraft from the Black Hawk Down days.
And this one carries a lot more people.
Yeah,
3, 8, 11.
pleasure. Thank you.
Yeah, and if you keep this shit up, you're going to have to take residency in Twin Falls.
Shoveling.
These are the two same ones that were in Boise a while back.
They are. That's how I knew about them.
How you been? You got your
glasses. Yeah, there you go.
That's a bad spot to be in.
That metal is so thin. And then I came in here.
I squeezed
this twin branding.
I'm trying to get.
Why not hard to do? Something like that.
Right here is going to be your main exit where the ladder is. Okay? If by some for some reason that is not accessible, you see that little bubble on the top of the right above where the front window is, where the big...
Yes.
Okay, there's a bubble right there. There's just latches that are safety wired shut. Please don't tamper with them unless you have to get out, but you just break those safety wires, take that out, and you can go out through the top of the hatch. There is a rope ladder up there that helps you go down over the fuselage if you need to come out. Okay? The rest of you, your main exit is going to be the door you're going to go in the back. Also, in the radio operator's room, it's four latches. You do that, you bring the window down, and we've got a rope that's going to go out over the side, and you're going to go out through that. Pilot's windows are also considered exits, but I always tell everybody pilot's windows are probably going to be full of pilot's butts going out themselves. So, just and in all seriousness, I have crewed on this aircraft for 39 years. I've been on it when we've blown an engine. We don't get excited. You just sit down. They go into emergency procedures. We still have three perfectly good engines. I've never had a time in it where I could say I was ever scared. Okay, so we're probably never going to have a problem, but we have to let you know how to get out in case. I will be directing you to what is probably the safest exit at the time. Okay, so just follow my directions. Like I said, I'm going to assign you seats within the fuselage. Once we go in, you're going to sit next to me, so I'm going to have you go on last.
Okay.
Once we are airborne, they will let me know from the cockpit when you can stand up and walk around. You two are going to be in the front.
Right.
Stay in that compartment. Don't try to come out. And after we land, you might see them out walking around. Do not come out of there until the flight crew chief comes and tells you it's okay to exit there. Because hot props can kick over by themselves, and you're going to be coming out right close to propellers, so they want you to stay there until the crew chief comes and gets you. Those of you in the back, like I said, they're going to let us know when you can get up and walk around. You can walk around from the bulkhead that goes out onto the catwalk. We do not allow you out on the catwalk. Those doors are designed to open at 110 pounds. You get out there, and the catwalk is 12 inches wide. You get out there, and we hit some turbulence, and you fall off, you will be exiting the aircraft. No refund for prematurely leaving the
airport.
So no one on the catwalk. No one gets near the back door. We close it, but we don't lock it, so that in case we are in trouble, we can get it open. But it is also designed to be jettisoned. So if you pull the wrong handle, the door and you will leave the aircraft. And it's really hard to find a new B-17. But seriously, I will probably be standing near the door where you can't get to it. But those are two things. Also, there are cables that run the length of the aircraft. Do not use those cables as your handholds, because if you're holding onto the cables, you're controlling the aircraft. The pilot is not. Okay? Makes them really cranky. But in all seriousness, that could cause us to crash. We do not, so no hand, hanging on to handles. I want you to think about when you're up there, you know, why are we up there? Yeah, it's fun to fly around on a warbird, but why are we there? The kids that flew in this thing during World War II, you know, it's 50 to 70 degrees below zero inside that fuselage for 8 to 10 hours at a time. The four in the front were officers, so they ranged in age between 22 and 25. The six kids in the back were 17 to 19. And they fought and bought your freedom. So when you're up there, and the consistency of the airplane, the fuselage, two beer cans. That's how thick it is. Nothing was armored, so anything that came through one side of the plane just went straight through and out the other side, and hope you weren't in the middle. Yeah.
How long is the flight?
You're in the aircraft approximately 45 minutes because we have, once we get in, it's going to seem like we're there forever. What they're doing is waiting for the oil temperature to come up. Okay? Once the oil temperature comes up, then we're going to start moving. You're going to feel a little jerk. That's when they're doing the brake check. Then we're going to go out to the run-up area, and they're going to run up all the engines. They run up two on one side, then two on the other side, then all four. What we're doing is checking the magnetos, making sure everything works as advertised before we ever go up there. Okay, so we're looking for anything that might be a discrepancy before we actually go airborne. Once we're 92 knots, we're off the ground. Coming in, 90 knots, we're landing. I will allow you to stand as long as possible. So when I get, and once I put my headset on, I can no longer talk to you. So we're going to use hand signals. When it's time to stand up, those that are sitting around me, I'm just going to tap you on the knee and tell you you can stand up. When I want you to sit down, it's down, put your seatbelts on. Okay? At that point, no more pictures, no more, you know, go to your chair and sit down. Like I said, I will let you stand as long as I can. Go back to the same chair you started from, because your seatbelts will be adjusted for you. So you can get into them quicker, so
all
just
right.
Go back to the same chair. There goes. These two gentlemen.
Okay, who's going in the nose first?
Who's going to take the bombardier's chair? Who's taking the bombardier's chair for takeoff?
I'll take the bombardier's chair.
Okay. Once you get in the aircraft, line the seat so it's straight across, okay? It's like a stenographer chair, and sit down. Now, lift your leg over it. Do not sit in the chair and try and turn. Your knees will not take off the bomb site, I guarantee it. A lot of people have tried. 10 minutes into the flight, actually, when wheels come up, the person in the back can stand up. Okay, don't stand up, you'll bump your head.
He's going to be in the
10
nose.
Minutes. Huh?
Yeah, he's in the nose with nose. You.
Yeah.
You're
he's
both in the nose.
Navigator seat. So what happens at 10 minutes into the flight, you're going to switch seats. Okay, same
so
thing.
So you'll go from the nose where you were sitting to the navigator seat. He'll move up to the nose.
Well, he wants to take the, we're going to start taking the photographs.
I could just hand you this.
Okay. Okay, we'll do
okay. That. And I'm still, two people have signed in and like disappeared.
Although I thought that my seat was going to be facing the other way.
Facing towards the wall?
No, off to starboard.
You right there in the nose?
Yes.
Yep. Guy has to stand out here with a fire hydrant for takeoff.
Capacity 600 written rounds for these for this case back here.
Capacity is what?
Capacity 600 rounds for this for this 50 back here. I think that's my right side. Hello?
That's an old time sound.
Oh yeah, there's a guy with a fire extinguisher. Oh, I think the right that air is gonna be nice.
Yes.
Where's the Gengar?
If you listen, you can hear him checking off.
Mm-hmm. Set 850.
Yeah, this bubble here, that's for to help navigate by the stars if you need to.
Three.
That's why it was put in place.
We hold in the proper order.
Three. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven,
eight, nine. You do me a favor.
going.
I'll hand this up to you.
Now, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but I might have missed the moment on your camera. Because I was hitting this button up here, and it kept stopping it.
No, it's a, okay, it will take motion pictures. Is that orange light on?
It is now, because I got it recording again.
Okay.
But
okay, that turns it off and on, and you can take pictures same time you record motion picture.
Okay, well, check it to make sure.
Well, probably when we get home.
Yeah, remember, we can't leave until they
right.
They come and get us. Wow. Oh, I gotta tell you, some of those dips were something else.
Some of the what?
The dips.
Oh.
Sitting there flying along, all of a sudden the plane just drops down like a foot.
You good now?
Okay, B17G,
which would indicate it's been greatly modified since the A model.
Hey, guys, play.
Is he saying to come on out?